Okay, so we talked about the closure of regular languages under union, concatenation, and star. So we said that regular languages are closed under union, concatenation, and star. And in fact, there is another operation that we showed that regular languages are closed under, which is complementation. We showed that regular languages are closed under complementation. How? How did we show that? So we showed that regular languages are closed under union by showing that if you give me an NFA for language 1 and an NFA for language 2, I can always construct an NFA for the union by using epsilon transitions. So I can give you an NFA. And we did the same for concatenation and for star. Now, how did we show that we can construct an NFA or a DFA for the complement? Was it an NFA or a DFA? If I give you an NFA for a language, can you construct an NFA for the complement? Or is it the DFA that you can construct?
DFA.
Yeah, DFA. We said that we can do it for DFAs. So given a DFA for a language, regular language, of course, we can always construct a DFA for the complement. How?
Swapping and accept states.
Yeah, exactly, by swapping accept and non-accept states. But it has to be a DFA. We showed an example why it doesn't work for NFAs, right? Yeah. I mean, if you have a start state that has 0-1 in it, and whatever comes after that, if you change this to an accept state, you'll always accept everything. The complement by swapping accept and non-accept states. Now, what about the intersection? So are regular languages closed under intersection? In fact, we have answered this question, but not explicitly. We have implicitly answered this question about the intersection. How? So, given two DFAs for two different languages, can you construct a DFA for the intersection? So we did this for the odd-even example. That's a very important example, by the way, the odd-even example. So you have the language L1 W such that W has an odd number of zeros, and language L2 W such that W has an odd number of ones. What's the intersection between these two? The intersection is L, where the string has an odd number of zeros and an odd number of ones, and. So the intersection is and. The union is or, and the intersection is and. So how do we construct an NFA or a DFA for the and? So we have to keep track of all the states, the cross product of the states. So if this has, you know, Q1 and Q2, and this has, let's call them R1 and R2, then the states in the DFA that will recognize the intersection will have to look at the cross product. In this example, the cross product is you know, odd, 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 even, 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 odd, right? The cross product here has four states. So you do Q1R1, Q1R2, and Q2R1, Q2R2. Now, in general, now forget about this simple example. In general, if you have Q1, Q2, all the way to Qn, and you have R1, R2 to Rm, then your intersection, the DFA that recognizes the intersection, will have to keep to track both properties, right? So a string that belongs to the intersection is an intersection that satisfies two different properties at the same time. In this case, the first property is odd number of zeros. The second property is odd number of ones. A string that belongs to the intersection is a string that satisfies both properties. And you can detect that only by looking at the intersection, at the cross product of the states. So you have to track Q1R1, Q1R2, all the way to Q1Rm. And you have to do Q1R1, Q2R2, all the way to Q2Rm, and QNR1, QNR2, all the way to QNRM. Okay, so this is a high-level description of a DFA that recognizes the intersection. Now the question for next time is, without thinking about this, think more mathematically. How can you prove, using the fact that regular languages are closed under union and regular languages are closed under complementation, how can you use this mathematically to prove that regular languages are closed under intersection?